Hi, I'm Dan with DJ2 Motorsports, and in this video we're going to talk about spring rate versus spring load. Hi, and welcome back to the videos. In this video, we're going to talk about coil springs. We've got our AFCO Racing coil springs that we got from Summit Racing. And there are a number of things that we need to look at on coil springs to make sure they fit our application. One is the diameter, of course. And this is a 5-inch diameter spring here on the yellow one. And the black one is 5.5-inch diameter. And of course, the height, which will also help set our ride height. And this is a 9.5-inch tall spring. And then the black one is 11-inch tall spring. The biggest thing that we need to take into consideration is the spring rate. And what the spring rate is the amount of weight that it will take to compress this 1-inch. And that's almost all springs are rated that way, especially coil springs. So this one, for example, is a 700-pound spring. So it will take 700 pounds to compress this 1-inch. So if we take 1,400 pounds on this, it will compress it 2 inches. The black spring here is a 900-pound spring, so it'll take 900 pounds of weight to compress this spring 1 inch. The other thing that we need to take into consideration is the spring load, and the spring load of a spring is the amount of weight that this can support before it's totally compressed. So if the maximum amount the spring can be compressed is 6 inches, with our rating of 700 pounds per inch, that would give us a spring load, and this is just theoretical on this spring. So if we compress the spring 6 inches before it will stop compressing, and the spring rate is 700 pounds per inch, that'll give us a load of 4,200 pounds. And basically all we're doing is taking the 700 pounds per inch times the 6 inches that it's compressed. Now on the black spring, since it's a 900-pound spring, and we'll just say theoretically that our maximum compression on this is 8 inches, then this spring load will be 7,200 pounds. So it's real easy to figure out. Most of these springs, like for example on this one from AFCO, they always etch the rating of the springs on the bottom here. And that's a really easy way to find out. But if you can find out the maximum compression and multiply that by your spring rate, then that is the easiest way to figure out what the spring total load of that spring will be. Okay, just to recap real quick, we talked about the spring rate, which is the amount of weight it takes to compress the spring 1 inch, and then we also talked about the spring load, how to calculate that, and you basically just take the maximum compression of that spring, multiply it by the spring rate, and you'll get your maximum load approximately for that spring. And again, thanks to Summit Racing for hooking us up with these springs from AFCO Racing. And make sure you look below this video and like it and hook up with us on Twitter and Facebook. And we'll see you inside the next video.